So, good morning students. Let us continue our chapter. Chapter number 4, Mughal Empire, its establishment and extension. In the last class or in the last video, we have discussed about the administrative process of Akbar and his policy towards other religions, how he respected the other religions and how he maintained good relations with the Rajput rulers, and therefore he succeeded in ruling our country and became one of the most loved or tolerant king among all the Mughal emperors of India. So we are continuing this class from there, the administrative system. So as we know, during Akbar's time, pilgrim tax was not there or not levied. That means a tax called jizya was there. Jizya was a religious tax. So when we are talking about pilgrim tax, we are talking about jizya. Jizya was a pilgrim tax that was given by non-Muslims to the emperor of India. But when Akbar came to power, he abolished jizya, the religious tax. Therefore, so many crowds of people can be seen in the pilgrimage center during the rule of Akbar. So, Akbar is considered to be the most tolerant king among all the Mughal rulers. Now, the royal court was adorned by various scholars. When we are talking about Akbar, then we have to remember that his court was full of many and different types of renowned scholars and historians. And in this class, let us study about his nine gems or nine gems of Akbar. जिसे हम हिंदी में नौ रत्न बोलते हैं, उसे हम पढ़ेंगे. Now the nine gems of Akbar were Todarmal, the revenue minister. So the very first name that we have to remember is Todarmal. He was the revenue minister, or we can say that he was the finance minister in the court of Akbar. Second, Man Singh. Man Singh was the leader of the army, or we can say the senapati of Akbar was Man Singh. Third, Abul Fazl, the historian and writer of Ain-e-Akbari and Akbarnama. So both these biographies were written by Abul Fazl based on the lives of Muhammad Jalaluddin Akbar, his achievement and success about his ruling period and all the development that took place during the time of Akbar was written in Akbarnama. Now Mulla Dopiyaza, the clever and jolly courtier. There were many persons who were very fond and were clever and jolly courtiers. Among them there are two, Mulla Dopiyaza and Mahesh Das Birbal. We are very much familiar with Birbal, as we have studied from our childhood days about Akbar and Birbal. He was also in the court of Akbar. Next one, Hammam. Hammam means the famous Vaidya or physician. He was the doctor in the court of Akbar. Faizi, the renowned poet. Poet means he was the most famous poet in the court of Akbar at that time. Then we have Abdul Rahim. Abdul Rahim was the Hindi verse writer and one of the significant writers and historians on the time of the court of Akbar. And many of the Urdu language books and many English literatures that we study are many being translated into Hindi by this court poet. So this was some of the administrative process that we have to remember about the Mughals, especially the Mughal emperor Akbar and his nine gems. We have to remember, and that is very much important for our examination. So we'll continue the next video. In the next session, we'll study more about the administrative process and reforms made by Sher Shah Suri.